Welcome to E Padasala PG program for computer science students. Today we will be looking at RTOS, the basic concepts. In this module, we will be discussing about the basics of real-time operating system. Then we will be discussing about the different types of RTOS systems, and the different functions of RTOS also will be discussed. So at the end, we will be discussing about the different RTOS softwares which are available in the market, and what is the features of that particular software. So all those things will be discussed in this particular module. So when you are looking at a real-time operating system, first we need to know why we need to go for an operating system of a special kind which will be used in embedded system. So the first thing is, we will be knowing that the embedded systems will be used in the real world. That means almost all the embedded systems are real time systems. So when you are looking at real time, we need the operating system should have certain capability. So the first thing is, the operating system should work with real time. That means the ability of the operating system is to provide a required level of service in a bounded response time. So that is the basic requirement when you are looking at operating system which is used in embedded systems. So when you are looking at RTOS, this supports whatever be the need which we require from your embedded systems. So in this RTOS, actually the RTOS responds to inputs immediately, which is given in real time. Here the task is completed within a specific time delay. We need to complete a particular task with certain time, with the specified time delay. And the real time situations like controlling a traffic signal or a nuclear reactor or controlling a flight, all these things which is requiring only real time operating system. There all these embedded systems, whatever the embedded systems, we are using it with these applications which requires it has to respond to the input immediately, as well as it has to complete the task within the specified time delay. So because of that, people are preferring real time operating systems with embedded systems. So now, why we need to go for your RTOS? That is a major question. So with the RTOS, we have so many drivers. So we can use directly the drivers which are available with your RTOS for building up your applications. And we can focus on developing applications instead of concentrating on either creating or maintaining a scheduling system. And multi-threaded support with synchronization is supported by your RTOS. And the portability of application to other CPUs also will be allowed when you are looking at your RTOS. So the major thing is the resource handling. How the RTOS is handling the resources is also very, very important when you are looking at embedded system development. So then the new features can be added without affecting the higher priority functions. So these, it will support, this RTOS supports the upper layer protocols, for example, TCP/IP, USB, the flash systems and web servers. So because of that, we will be preferring RTOS than your normal OS for your embedded systems. When you are looking at RTOS, what are all the requirements needed for the RTOS is also a major thing to be considered. So the first thing is, the timing behavior of the OS must be predictable. If it is not predictable, then it will not be of use. So the RTOS should have the timing behavior should be predictable. And for all service of the OS, there is an upper bound on the execution time. Always, whatever be the service we are doing it, we will be having an upper bound on the time. So within that, I have to execute my task. And the scheduling policy must be deterministic. So when you are looking at RTOS, it should have a policy to schedule the works. So that policy should be deterministic. And The period during which interrupts are disabled must be short to avoid a delay. So when you are looking at the interrupts, many of the normal OS, the interrupts will be given the topmost priority and it will be serviced at the time when you are requesting for interrupts, when the system is requesting for a service. But here, because it is a smaller system, the interrupts are disabled for a very short time. So that also should be tolerable by your RTOS. And the OS possibly has to aware of task deadlines. So whatever be the task, we will be running it with your RTOS, it has to keep it in its mind when it has to be, when at least at what time it has to be finished. That means the deadlines of each task has to be maintained by RTOS. Then frequently the OS should provide the precise time services to with the high resolution. And the next thing is it should be very fast. So these are the requirements when you are looking at your RTOS. And there are different types of RTOS are there. One is soft real time, another one is hard real time RTOS. So when you are looking at soft RTOS there, the tasks are performed as fast as possible and the late completion of the jobs is undesirable, but it is not fatal. It can finish after certain scheduled time. That will not collapse the system. That's what they are trying to say. It gives you a degraded performance, that's all. So the system performance degrades as more and more jobs miss the deadlines. Example is online database. So when you are looking at online database, when you are accessing a query or when you are putting a query on the online database, we'll be expecting that the result should come very fast. But if it is slow, we'll not say that we'll not use it. We'll use it, but we'll think that it is very slow. So we'll say that we can't decide it with a faster time. We cannot discard this particular application. We have to run, but we need it in a faster way. So we can say that if it is delayed, the query is process delayed, then we'll say that the results are coming late. So that never collapses the system. That's all. That is the major task. When your major thing will be looking at your soft real time RTOS. When you are looking at hard real time, there, the hard real-time RTOS there, the task has to be performed on time. So the second thing is the failure to meet deadlines is fatal. For example, flight control system. If the flight control system doesn't respond within that particular deadline, then it will crash or some injury will happen, some accident will happen. So we need to think about the hard real-time system with respect to some of the things where we need the task has to be executed within the time and it should respond very fast. It should not exceed the deadlines. So that kind of things is nothing but hard real-time system. Example is your flight control system. So when you are looking at the RTOS, we know very well, first we need to know about the architecture of your RTOS. So the basic architecture of multitasking RTOS includes the program interface, the kernel, the device drivers and the optimal service models. So when you are looking at these things, the kernel provides the interrupt handler. So when you are looking at this is the architecture where in the kernel you just see that we have interrupt dispatch, memory management, scheduling, real-time clock, your file management, inter-process communication and logic and character IO and loader, all these things are available with your kernel services. When you are looking at device drivers, we will be supporting disk, mic, miscellaneous, network, parallel and serial port. So all those things is supported with your device drivers, whereas the networking is supported with your, networking with the other things which will be supported through this particular one. So streaming is also supported. So when you are looking at the architecture of RTOS, where we'll be having this kernel which provides the interrupt handler, task scheduler, resource sharing, flags and memory management, the primary functions to process interrupts and interrupts from external and internal devices, and the scheduler which schedules the execution of the application codes. So these are the major components of architecture of your RTOS. So when you are looking at the good RTOS, then what are all the requirements for the good RTOS is also to be known. So for that particular thing, first thing is the good RTOS should have multitasking capability. That means the real-time application is divided into multiple tasks. So the separation into task helps to keep the CPU busy. And the second thing is the short input latency. So here the latency time is nothing but the hardware delay, I mean it is a summation of the times which includes the hardware delay to get interrupt signal to the processor and time to complete the current instruction and time to execute the system code in the preparation for transferring the execution to the devices of interrupt handler. So all these things are combined together to make the interrupt latency. So this interrupt latency should be very small. That is required for a good RTOS and fast context switching. So when you are looking at context switching is performed, that means if the scheduler is making one if the scheduler schedules one task to next, the different task has to be executed, it is scheduling it to the different tasks, then the context switching will occur. So during the context switch, the time taken should be very less. So these are the requirements for a good RTOS. We have some other points also to be considered for the requirement. One is the control of memory management, because we have with your embedded systems, we have a very less memory, so we need to maintain it properly. And the proper scheduling, the OS should provide the facility to schedule properly the time constraint task. So the fine when you are looking at the timer services, the millisecond resolution is bare minimum. That means microsecond resolution is required for many cases. So that has to be maintained. The rich set of inner task communication mechanism is also has to be maintained with your message queues, shared memory, synchronization, and even flags and all those things. So when you are looking at the major points to be considered with whichever be the RTOS is consistency, your reliability, scalability, predictability, and performance. So these are the things which has to be considered when you are looking at your RTOS services. So when you are looking at the functions of RTOSs, the RTOS does many things, but these are the major things which it does. One is the task management, another one is scheduling of the task, and the resource allocation with the different multiple tasks and interrupt handling. So these are the four things it has to be maintained. I mean the RTOS has to do it with without having any problem, as well as it has to use the CPU optimum, and the CPU time has to be utilized properly with managing all these things. So when you are looking at task management, where in real time applications the process is called as task, where which takes the execution time and occupies memory. The task management is the process of managing tasks through its life cycle. So when you are looking at the states of the tasks are pending, it is in a pending state, ready state, delayed state, suspended state, and running state. So the pictorial representation of the different states existing in your task is ready state, delayed state, running state, suspended state, and pending state. So when you are looking at these are the states with which the tasks is existing, and with this the scheduling is done. So when you are looking at that different states, each task or the process can belong to any one of the one state only, and the scheduler only operates on the process in a ready state only. So the scheduler will schedule only the process which will be available with ready state. There is only a single process in the run or current state at any time. So the CPU will execute only at a time, one CPU will execute only one process. So the transition to and from the ready queue are affected as a part of the execution of the RTOS resource or the object services, the resource services, or as a result of timing events. So when you are looking at transition from the ready queue to running queue is due to availability of resources or availability of certain services, that means some object code is needed. So typical task operations are creating and deleting task, controlling the task scheduling, obtaining the task information. So when you are looking at scheduling with respect to RTOS, we know that scheduling is a very important task with respect to operating systems. In RTOS, still it is very important. That means we will be giving more importance towards schedulers. So here, the more information about the task should be known by the schedulers. First thing is the how many number of tasks is available, what are all the resources required for running the task, and how much is the execution for each and every task, and what is the deadline for each task. So if the RTOS knows all these things, then only it can schedule the things properly. So the scheduling algorithms, so if I am knowing all these parameters, but the scheduler has to run certain algorithm, based on that only it schedules the different task which is allotted for running with that particular system. So when you are looking at the scheduling algorithms, the major division is, one is non-priority algorithm, another one is priority based algorithm. So when you are looking at non-priority, where we will be looking at only the logic, we'll be given equal performance, equal importance to all the tasks. There is no priority, and it has been assigned with a one particular schedule which never gives importance to any of the tasks, which it considers all the tasks in the equal priority, and it schedules with fairness. So one example is clock driven scheduling, another one which is round robin scheduling. So when you are looking at priority scheduling, where I can say that it is a greedy or event driven or list driven kind of scheduling, example is rate monotonic scheduling. So when you are looking at this priority scheduling, this will be used mostly with your RTOS. So the clock driven, when you are looking at we'll be looking at the scheduling algorithms in detail with a different module, but anyway we'll be just looking at what are all the algorithms which are available in scheduling. So first one is your clock driven, where all parameters about the job is known in advance, it can be schedulable, and it can be computed offline. Schedules can be computed offline with respect to this clock driven, and at some irregular time instances also the schedules can be computed. Minimum runtime is overhead and not suitable for many of the applications. So this non-priority based clock driven algorithm is not that much suitable for many of the applications. And when you are looking at weighted round robin, where the jobs are scheduled in first come first out manner, so whoever comes to the queue first will be scheduled first. So based on that we will be looking at weighted round robin, where the time quantum given to the jobs is proportional to its weight. So based on the weight we will be doing it. It is almost a priority kind of thing only, but it works with round robin kind of fashion. So the high speed switching network is one particular with the example is your QoS guarantee is given with your high speed switching network because of using this weighted round robin scheduling algorithm. But it is not suitable for precedence constrained jobs. That means a job A can run only after job B, then no point in giving time quantum to job B before job A. So that kind of constraints will not suitable for many of the applications. So when you are looking at priority based scheduling, there we will be having something like the processors never left idle when there are ready tasks. So when you are looking at the previous cases, job A or job B is scheduled in 1 and 2 slots, then if job 1 is not ready, then his slot will not be used by others. So there will be a waste. That means as idle time is also available with respect to your scheduling. So here the priority scheduling, we don't have any idle time, and the processes are allocated to the processes according to priorities. And we have two kinds of priorities, one is static priority and another one is dynamic priority. And when you are looking at EDF, which is nothing but earliest deadline first, is a dynamic priority scheduling, whereas the static is the rate monotonic. So these are the things which we have to see when you are looking at your real-time operating systems. So the next major task done by your RTOS is the resource allocation. So when you are looking at the resource allocation in RTOS, the first thing is the system should know what are all the resources which are available for giving to the task to process. What are all the resources which is allocated for doing this particular task, multiple task. For that, how many resources are there? So that first the RTO should know. Then the issues with the scheduling applicable here. We have to take care about what will be the issues which are all associated with this particular scheduling. And the resources can be allocated in, still again it can be allocated in like your scheduling algorithms as like weighted round robin or priority based. Some resources are non preemptable. So example is semaphores, where you can't preempt this kind of resource. So the priority inversion, if the priority, I mean priority inversion also can be done if you wanted to have a dynamic priority based allocation with respect to your resources. So the other RTO, real time operating system issues are, one is the interrupt latency. It should be very small. What they are trying to say over here is, if a particular device is asking for interrupt service, so when it is requesting the time from that time onwards, the system should understand who is asking for the service. Then it has to identify where its ISR routine is, and it has to save whatever be the status of the current running process, which has to be kept in a PCB or TCB. Then for this ISR, which is identified for the device which is requesting for the service, we have to load that particular code. So because of that, all the things which is needed for that particular device, maybe the device driver as well as the whatever be the service routine is needed, has to be loaded to the system to run that particular task. So when it requests and when the system is executing its service routine, in between there is so much task, so much things has been done. So the time taken to start, once it gets a request, it has to start it. But in between the system has to do so many works. So because of that, there is a time delay over there, which is nothing but the latency time. And this latency time should be very small with when it is coming to the position of a RTOS. That means we are looking at a real time operating system which is worked out with your embedded systems. So if I am pressing a particular button, that means I am requesting for a service. So I have wanted to run a particular routine. So if that is the case, I need that particular code has to be run immediately. So I'm willing to see only the time delay should be in microseconds. So then only the embedded system will be appreciated. This task is taken by RTOS, so which makes the latency time becomes very small. And for embedded applications, the kernel size should be very small. That means when you are looking at your embedded system where the memory will be very, very small, so because of that, the kernel size also should be small. Whatever be the thing we are using, it should fit into the read-only memory of your embedded system. And the sophisticated features can be removed. So no virtual memory will be available and no protection should be given. So all these memory problems also has to be taken care when it is looking at this RTOS process. So interrupt handling of your RTOS is, first the interrupt is a signal from a device. Then the main program which is operating to the system should be passed, that means to be put under a waiting state. We have to process the interrupts, I mean the interrupt service routine for the system asking the service. So when you are looking at your RTOS, this particular, as we know that it is of a very special nature and it is used for a real time applications only. So this will be used in telecommunication kind of systems. Modern telecommunication kind of systems will use RTOS, as well as the radar systems, network switching control systems, satellite monitoring systems, and satellite launch control and maneuvering mechanisms, and global GPS systems. All these things has been controlled with RTOS only. So nowadays RTOS are increasingly finding use in the strategic and military operations. So these are used in guided missile launching units as well as track and trace spy satellites. So by looking at the applications described here, with which you will be understanding how much the RTOS has to how much time, how much issues the RTOS has to concentrate, so that it has to work very fast, it has to use only the CPU time less, and the task has to be done without any delay. So, for these kind of applications, people are looking at RTOS. So, in the market, so when you are looking at this RTOS in the market, we will be having VxWorks, PSOS, ECOS, or the different operating RTOS things are available in the market. Whereas, many people are working with VxWorks, where these schedulers with your RTOS, real time operating systems, we have all your schedulers are preemptive schedulers. As well as when you are looking at the kernel size with the PSOS, it is 16 KB, and multiprocessor support has to be done by these RTOS. So, when you are looking at this RTOS, this VxWorks finding very important in the embedded system development works. So, when you are looking at VxWorks, it is the most established and most widely deployed device software operating system, where currently there are more, there are more than 300 million devices that are VxWorks enabled. So, the core attributes of your VxWorks includes high performance, the reliability, determinism, low latency and scalability. So, this VxWorks is created by WinDriver, and it is having an enhanced error management, and the backward compatibility to previous versions features for exception handling and template support. So, extensive POSIX 1003.1 or 0.1b or 0.1c compatibility is also available. So, when you are looking at the scheduling of this VxWorks, it is having a preemptive priority based round with round robin scheduling is accommodated with real time as well as non real time process. So, the memory protection is MMU based memory protection is given with your VxWorks, and the context switch time is having a very very less time. It has they can say that negligible context text switching time. That means it saves only those registers register windows that are actually in use, and the task context is restored, only the relevant register window is restored. So, to increase response time, it saves the register windows in a register cache only. So, it is very useful for recurring task. So, they say that the context switching time is reduced very very less, maybe they are comparing it is a negligible context switching time. So, when you are looking at this particular lecture, we have discussed about the basics of real time operating system, then we discussed about the different types of RTOS, that is soft RTOS or hard RTOS, and what are all the works or the functions done by the RTOS is also discussed, and at the end we have discussed about the different RTOS softwares which are available in the field. So, in this we have discussed about the features about VxWorks RTOS also. So, you can refer these things for this RTOS basics. Thank you.